first days of the Thanksgiving parade on New York's Broadway. Celebrating the turkey feasting holiday, hundreds lined the streets to catch a glimpse of the air-filled happiness. Sadly, many Americans celebrated their Thanksgiving in breadlines or in soup kitchens together this year. Millions are still out of work, most of which have become homeless and are now living in slums in shantytowns in Hooverville. No jobs, no work, no food, no homes. In a nation with a population well over 100 million, half of America has no visible means of support. Matters got worse this week when famed industrialist Oliver Wolbox announced that he closed 6 more of his factories. When America's richest man is tightening his belt, you know the country is in trouble.
Maybe in a house, all hidden Who's happy here? Well,
we love you, Miss Hannigan.
Sure. Well, if you're so wide awake, you can get up! Get out of bed and clean up this place! This room had better be regulation before breakfast, my little pig. Drop things or kill, kill, kill!
But it's the middle of the night.
But it's the middle of the night. And if this room don't shine at the top of the Chrysler Building, your backsides will. Understood?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
What do you say, Annie?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
Why anyone would want to be an orphan is beyond me.
Today, Miss Hannigan.
Oh, Mr. Bendels, thank you.
Ooh.
Get back inside, you monsters! Faster! I'll be right here when you get
Bye,
back.
Bye, Miss Hannigan.
Bye.
Thank you, Mr. Bendels.
Oh, you're welcome. Be careful out here.
Oh, don't worry about me.
Thank you.
teacher. Could you donate an apple to the orphans' picnic center?
Yeah. Who likes a penny?
Gee, thanks, mister.
Say, when is the orphans' picnic?
As soon as I take a bite.
Apples, apples.
She's fine, so no harm done, huh?
But,
Miss Hannigan, whatever are you talking about?
Oh, wait a minute, honey. Are you peddling beauty products? Because clearly I don't need no beauty products.
I'm the private secretary of Oliver Warbucks.
Oliver Warbucks, the millionaire?
No, Oliver Warbucks, the billionaire.
My lord.
Mr. Warbucks would like to invite an orphan to spend a week with him at his house.
Well, isn't that nice? What sort of orphan did he have in mind?
Well, it doesn't really matter. Friendly, intelligent.
MISSISSIPPI.
And happy.
How old?
Age doesn't really matter. Seven.
Seven?
Eight.
Eight?
Nine.
Nine?
Ten?
Ten.
Ten. Ten is perfect. Oh, and I almost forgot. Mr. Warbucks prefers redheaded children.
Ten-year-old redhead? No, sorry. Ain't got it.
Well, what about this child right here?
Annie? You don't want Annie?
Well, why not?
Because she's a drunk.
Fiddlesticks. Annie, how would you like to spend a week at Mr. Warbucks' house?
Oh boy, I would love that!
Slow down, hold on. You can have any child in the whole orphanage, but not Annie.
Well, why?
Well, because she's got it coming for her, and I don't mean a week in the lap of luxury. This brat's got to learn her place.
Her place?
Annie's entirely too cheeky.
Well, Mr. Warbucks loves cheeky orphans.
So?
Miss Hannigan, I assume your objection has something to do with the New York Board of Orphans and Mr. Donnelly.
Don't assume nothing, sweetheart.
Well, Mr. Warbucks and Mr. Donnelly are like that.
Is that a fact?
Yes. Oh, and he was at the house just the other day saying how many people he had lined up for your job.
Is that a fact?
Yes, that's a fact. It's an awful time to be out of work, isn't it, Miss Hannigan?
It's terrible.
Come on, honey.
Leaping lizard!
Leaping lizard!
Wait a second. Come on, Donna. This is my daughter, Donna. She's real sweet, and she almost never jumps up on people.
I'm sure she's a very sweet dog, Annie. But, I don't think Mr. Warbucks would approve. What?
She said she would take her to the sausage factory.
I'm not a sucker for dogs.
We're taking the dog.
Oh, boy!
Where are all the servants?
Well, as you may see, they're taking a break right now. They'll be here soon.
When will be soon?
Maybe in a couple of minutes. Well, okay. Here is Drake. He's our general butler. Very helpful and does the whole work in the house.
Oh, cool.
May I take your sweater?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear.
Sure.
Now, Annie. What would you like to do first?
The windows, then the floors, that's the
Annie. Annie, you don't understand. You won't have to do any cleaning while you're with us.
I won't? Then how will I earn my keep?
You are our guest, Annie.
Cecile will pick out all your clothes.
Louis is the best thing.
No, Red, I think.
Your bath is drawn by Mrs. Breer.
So, no, Bubbles, I think.
Annette comes in to make your bed.
The soup. No, the seven sheets.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
The swimming pool is on the left.
In the house? Oh boy!
The tennis court is in the rear.
I've never even picked up a racket.
Have an instructor here at noon.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
When you
break. Ring for Drake. Drake will bring your tray.
When you're through, Mrs. View, come and pay little bill.
But I
Someday I'll spread where the bread goes. Some night I'll straighten their curls. Send the blood, send the blue, anything that you can do to little girl. Someday I'll end in another house with all the nuts and the squirrels. There I'll stay tucked away till the prohibition of
they let me out early.
On account of his good behavior.
I want you to meet a little friend of mine. Lily St. Regis.
Name from the hotel.
Room service.
Well, I put today 10 on the nose of a beautiful horse at 10-1. And sure enough, the scumbum took off and whipped the pack.
No kidding.
Well, you see, unfortunately, I got delayed and didn't have time to cash in. $80, sis. First thing in the morning, guaranteed. All I need is five to tide me over.
Not even a nickel for the subway.
Oh, come on, sis, you know better.
I betcha Miss Sticky Fingers here can loan you some lousy $5.
I beg your pardon, I'm sure, but I don't stoop to what you're insinuating.
Give me back my goat's tooth.
Happy?
If I loan you $5, will you take this dumb hotel out of here?
Oh, sis, not even a nickel for the subway. Come on, let's go.
You and her have the same mother.
Well, what if I told you she was adopted?
I believe it.
No, you don't.
Stupid, it's only a hyperbole. Now come on now, we haven't got all day.
Please offer your son my congratulations on his engagement. Hold on. Bye, Copper. And please tell the Crown Prince that my house is in Monte Carlo and that it is entirely at his disposal. Hold on. Buy more Copper. Oh, this is too distracting. Don't encourage her, Punjab.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. Maybe I should take her out.
Where do you want her to go?
To meet President Roosevelt.
What about the movies?
Pepper's been to the movies once. She said it was swell before she came to the orphanage. And Miss Hannigan goes all the time.
Splendid. Take her to the Radio City Music Hall.
Aren't you gonna take me?
Me? And you might think that this girl does all the work around here, but that's not entirely true. As you can see, I'm a busy man, a very busy man.
I know. I didn't mean to get in the way, Mr. Wilcox. Nobody has to take me anywhere. I'll just practice my backhand. Pepper lies a lot. She probably hasn't been to the movies either. Actually, it's better when you don't know what you're missing.
Bonjour. About the show. Let's go to the movies.
Let's go see the stars.
Red and Ginger spinning merry songs and romance. Life is a dance. Sitting in the darkness, popcorn on your knee. Give the maid the night off.
And don't make your mind off.
Let's go to the movies, honey, you and me.
Red lights, roller, deep depression. What's up above?
Your daughter, Eliza!
Ha ha! You're lucky man, Alfie, you daughter.
What are you talking about? What about Eliza?
You don't know. They're on farm any day now.
And what things does she want? A birdcage and a Chinese fan!
Ha! I know she had a good career in front of her. Every boy went for a boot up. The sun is shining on Alfie Pay Yodo.
Go on, Alfie
Yodo! Our bed was made to help support his children. She had the right and proper thing to do. A man was made to help the Buddhist children. But move a little bit, I'll love, wait a little bit, I'll love. Yeah, I'm going to support you. The poorest bloke you'll ever hope to meet. He doesn't have a tuppence in his pocket, but with a little bit of luck, with a little bit of luck, he'll be living up to Eden Street.
She wouldn't be a bother. I take care of her. There's plenty of room here. The staff adores her. We could take her on as an ward, couldn't we?
Absolutely not. I'm a businessman. I love money. I love power. I love capitalism. I not now, nor ever will love children.
Seeing you with her last night, I thought that maybe...
Grace?
Yes?
I've just noticed something.
Yes?
You're awfully pretty when you argue with me.
Thank you, sir. That's...
Oliver,
Oliver, do you really just love money, capitalism, and power? You know they'll never love you back.
Your teeth are crooked.
I'll get them fixed.
I like them crooked.
I'll keep them.
Thank you.
I could have the adoption paper signed by this morning.
Grace.
Oliver?
It means a great deal to you, doesn't it?
Yes, it does mean a great deal to me.
I'll do it myself.
Thank you. I'm so glad. I could just really, I can't express how glad I am.
Grace, get her a little gift.
That's a great idea.
Something from Tiffany's. A new locket.
Yes, a new locket. And you be careful when you go back to that orphanage. That woman's got claws and fangs.
Thank you.
Miss Hannigan, aren't you, that thing? Give it to me.
Hannigan?
What?
Could I talk to you for a moment?
Mr. Horace?
I want to talk to you about Annie.
You want to return her and forget it or trade up?
I want to talk to her.
Would you excuse me for a moment?
Necessary. Please sign this document.
Are you sure, my good sir? It would be
right.
Far more appropriate. Oh, but I make a very dry martini.
Just your name.
And a very wet souffle.
Right here.
Don't be so mean, you mean meanie.
Come, now. Don't be silly. Sign the paper.
I...
Master.
Oh, to hell with it. Here you go.
Thank you, Miss Hannigan.
So, Duffy, why don't you show me what you're hiding?
Ah! Ah! Get inside, both of you! Ah!
Does he just want to get Tiffany sent back? Where is she?
I hear a car, sir.
It's probably not the right car.
It's the Duesenberg, sir.
I'm here.
What did you say? Where's Annie?
She's in her regular lesson, sir.
Oh, Oliver, don't be nervous.
Nervous? I'm not nervous. You give it to her.
Oh, no. It was your idea. You give it to her.
Well, she likes you more than she likes me.
Oliver, will you put yourself together?
Serious?
You don't want me anymore, right?
On the contrary, I do. Good Lord, Annie. Can we have a man-to-man talk?
Sure.
What I'm proposing would involve a long-term agreement. Actually, maybe you ought to know more about me before you make up your mind.
Okay.
Let's go for a walk.
Okay.
I was born in Budapest. My younger brother died of pneumonia because we didn't have money for medicine. Then and there, I decided that I would be rich. Very, very rich.
Good idea.
In those days, America was a land of opportunity. When I was 12, I signed on a ship as a cabin boy. By 12, I made my first million. In the next 10 years, I turned right into 100 million. In those days, that was a lot of money. I was ruthless. I hurt a lot of people. Making money was all I would give a damn about. Up till now. Let's sit down.
Okay.
I've realized that no matter how many houses I have, how many Duesenbergs, how many Rembrandts, unless I have someone to share it with, I might as well be broken back in Budapest. And do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Sure.
Good.
Kind of.
Kind of?
I guess not.
Damn. Oh, excuse me.
Mr. Warbix, you've given me so much already. I can't.
It's official. I've had the paper signed today.
What is?
Let me put it on you.
No. It's a small locket, Mr. Warbix. But if it's all the same to you, I'll keep my own.
It isn't all the same. Your old one's broken. This one's engraved. You didn't even look at it. Danny, we're left from Daddy Warbix.
Mr. Warbix, when my folks left me at the orphanage 10 years ago, they left a note saying they'd come back for me as soon as they could. And they kept the other half of the locket, so I know when they came. I'm going to find them someday, and have a regular mother and father, like a regular kid. I am. I don't mean to hurt your feelings, Mr. Warbix. You've been nicer to me than anybody in the whole wide world. But I've been dreaming of my folks for as long as I can remember, and I just gotta find them.
And I'll help you. Grace.
Yes?
Get Edgar on the phone.
Okay.
Drake.
Yes?
Get the chief of police.
Yes?
Martha.
Yes, sir.
Get the warrant show. Punjab.
Yes, sir.
Get William Randall first. And Saunders, get me a drink. Saunders, where are you?
Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, on the air.
Got your stuff, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Your lovely love, brother, they stand out a mile, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Tycoon, Oliver Warbix. Thank you, Bert Healy. It's swell. Swell? Do I see swell? It's swell to be an Aiden's hour.
I understand that you're conducting this coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents.
Yeah, I told you that before we went on there. Oh, yes. I'm now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. Drop page. Warbix continues. Furthermore, I'm offering a cash reward of $50,000 to Annie's parents.
Oh, Mr. oh boy, 50,000 smackers?
So, Annie's parents, if you're listening, please contact Oliver Warbucks. Warbucks interrupt at my house, 987 Fifth Avenue, New York City. Drop page. Thank you, Bert Healy, and thank you. I, the toothpaste of Miracle K6045, Hallie.
Hallie Joseph.
And for letting me talk to you this evening. Drop page. Did I just cut a commercial?
For all of you, our smiles and family, this is Bert Healy saying.
We are now standing before the famous industrialist Oliver Warbucks residence, where thousands of people are gathered today to try and prove the one and same thing, that they are indeed Annie's one and only parents. Let us see how many honest people there really are in New York. Oh, and who do we have here? The man himself, Mr. Warbucks. Oliver, what a great pleasure to see you again.
No comments. Grace, tell Mas to get the autocopter ready.
How do you feel about there being so many pretended parents claiming one child?
I simply hope we can see through their lies and bring truth to the surface.
Well, we wish you the best of luck. We cannot wait to learn who will be the winner in this most interesting contest. President Roosevelt has so far lived up to none of his campaign promises. All we've had from Franklin Roosevelt and his so-called brain trust is a great deal of vain talk and virtually no action. In a nation wrecked by poverty, misery, and unemployment, it is actions we want, not words. In short, Mr. President, if you are listening, it is time to do something about this and do it now.
Criticism, damn it! Nothing but criticism.
I know.
It's awful.
My friends, I say again, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Franklin, you've already been elected.
Every cloud has a silver lining. You're never fully dressed
without a smile!
I hate this phrase.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Good morning, Oliver. I'm glad you could come. Who do we have here?
This is my good friend Anne. I couldn't resist bringing her along because she just wanted to meet you so much.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Good morning, Anne. And pleasure is all mine. Thank you for bringing the old goat. We'll make a new dealer of him yet. Inconceivable. We'll see about that. Now, Anne, my Uncle Theodore used to teach his children how to walk on stilts.
I can't do that.
But I can teach you how to roll on the chair.
Welcome to my mall.
It's my own private roller coaster.
Well, Annie, why don't you wait outside and I'll be right there with you the second I'm done.
No. Annie can stay.
Having a child on our hands will have us all be on our best behavior. Harold, I don't want to hear so much as a gosh out of you. Now, Oliver, as you represent those few happy Americans with any money left whatsoever, I want to hear your opinion on the matter.
Thank you, Mr. President. In the words of George Coleman, the business of this country is business, and for the good of you, Mr. President, this country, Wall Street, and me, we ought to get back the unemployed and the workers back to work.
Good!
Yes, according to my latest calculation, 50 million of Americans are out of work, and 50 million with no means of support whatsoever.
Thank you.
Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our worst problem.
What?
The dispatches from Germany are becoming more and more disturbing each day. There could be war.
Germany? Hell, there are people starving in this country.
Harold, I know that, but then in the long run...
In the long run, people don't eat.
The trouble
is, Mr. President. It's so happening as it was again. The stock market is taking another blow.
Strikes, right. Is that what you want?
And the FBI still hasn't responded. So the situation is hopeless and it's getting worse.
I'd like you to take a look at this picture.
This is precisely what I believe as the New Deal.
The New Deal is badly planned, badly organized and administered. You don't think your program's through, frankly. You don't think what you're going to do to the economy in the long run.
Again, people don't eat in the long run.
People can't feed their children.
And the lucky ones are left in orphanages. They're the ones that are abandoned on the streets and steal not to starve.
The business of this country's business, you have to understand.
Take them off the dole and put them to work. That is precisely what I intend to do.
In national parks, catching fires and planting trees.
I want to feed them and house them and pay them. Not much, but enough so that they can send it home to their parents and be proud to be American.
That's a swell idea.
This isn't a swell idea, Annie. It's mistaken foolishness. Big-hearted and empty-headed. What parks? Which children? Who's going to pay for it? Who's going to organize it? Who's going to run it?
Well, I was hoping you would.
Me?
Absolutely not!
Leaping lizards! How can I help?
You can help, you can delight people. Many of them have even given up hope. They believe that their government doesn't care about them, doesn't care whether they live or die. With you, Annie, we could convince them otherwise, that with a little bit of extra effort on their part, they can.
I want to say something!
There's this song I used to sing in the orphanage when I was sad. It always cheered me up. The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just take out my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you tomorrow, you're always a day away.
Oh.
The sun will come out tomorrow. But you will
sing on it. That's an order from your commander in chief.
There'll be sun.
Helena, sing.
Just sing. I'll sing. Tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's sun.
The president, when I'm stuck with a debt, that's great and lonely. I just stick up my chin and grin and say, everyone sing, the public is too honored.
The sun will come out tomorrow, so we gotta hang on till tomorrow.
Unfortunately. 10 years ago, we left a little baby girl on the front steps.
There was a job managing a hotel, but only if you had no children.
Wrap it up. Well, we never meant to leave our little Annie. Annie?
And
that we have a hardware store in New Jersey, we can take care of her.
We've always loved her.
You're Annie's parents?
We live over the store.
There's a yard out back.
With chickens.
And a rooster.
Rooster, my God! I never would have recognized you.
If we fool you, we can fool the big bucks.
You'll be the death of me.
Come on, sis. This is going to be the biggest mumbo-bungo job ever.
50,000?
We need details first.
What's in it for me?
A three-way split of the $50,000.
You're cute. I want half.
Hey!
All right, half.
Rooster!
All right, 25 grand for me and Lil, and 25 grand for you. Deal?
Why don't we wait and see what she's got? See if it's worth 25 grand.
You want details? I've got details. I've got specifics on every kid in this dump. It's just a matter of finding the right box. Annie wears a locket around her neck. It's a broken locket. She says her parents came. She says her parents saved the other half to go and claim her with. Well, what she doesn't know is years ago, her parents were killed in a fire. The cops brought me all their junk. Well, my darling baby brother, if Annie's parents can claim her with that locket, then so can we.
50,000 slackers!
It's in an envelope, a sealed envelope.
It ain't fair how he scores for 3 or 4 bucks.
When she gets 4 bucks.
The little brat!
$50,000. Then we blow this crumbly old town, and then Lillian, I'll meet you.
Where?
Where?
Oh yeah.
Now let's go.
Okay.
What is this? Sometimes I wonder if I'm in the right family.
I think you are.
Right here. Well, Annie, I came back with really bad news. I interviewed 865 couples, and none of them knew about the locket. I really never knew how many dishonest people there are in New York.
Oh, geez. Are you certain?
Yeah.
I was sure somebody was going to be my mother and father.
Mr. Warbucks, this has just come from a special messenger from the FBI.
Finally. Ingen Gunderson Mash look at the manufacturer Fanny's Lucky, Netka, New York.
Oh boy!
Over 90,000 were made and sold.
Oh gee.
Annie, I'm afraid the FBI doesn't think there's a chance in a million of tracing your parents through the locket. Annie, I'm sorry.
That's okay. You did your best. Anyway, I guess the king could get along without folks. You didn't turn out so bad.
Grace?
Yes?
Do you still have the legal papers confirming Anne's
adoption? Right here.
Well, Annie, the choice is yours.
Would you like to have us as your parents?
Well, if I can't have my real mother and father, there's nowhere else in the world I'd rather have for father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
This needs to be a celebration, and you can have anyone in the world you want come to. Who would you like?
Well, I guess I'd like Miss Farrell, and Mr. Drake, and Mrs. Pugh, and well, everybody here.
Drake?
Yes, sir.
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. We're going to be guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and the kids.
It'll be way past her bedtime now, but I'll tell you what. We'll have everyone here tomorrow for a huge party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Why not? I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid.
Excuse us, folks. Oh, look. Shirley, there's your Annie.
Who are you?
Honey, we're your mom and dad.
Excuse me, sir. How
Mudge the name. Ralph Mudge, and this here is my wife, Shirley.
And you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge?
We've met a lot of people who...
I'll expect you'll be wanting proof of who we are, so here's Annie's birth certificate and our driver's license. There we go.
Baby girl, named Aunt Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, New York, October 28th, 1922.
October 28th, that's my birthday.
Look, Ralph, Annie's still got the locket.
Oh, you see, when we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half of this locket here, and half here, and half with her.
Oh, yes, it fits perfectly. Oh, Ralph, she's our Annie.
Mr. Mudge, what about the money?
Well, we ain't got much, but we're willing to give whatever.
You haven't heard that offer the certified check of $50,000 to Annie's parents?
No, sir.
Well, if you haven't heard my announcement, then how did you know that Annie was here?
That lovely lady at the orphanage told us.
Well, anyways, we don't want no money. I mean, we just want Annie.
On the other hand, Ralph, remember that little pig farm out in New Jersey? With $50,000, we could afford to raise little Annie, darling, upright in the country.
Wonderful idea.
Mr. and Mrs. Mudge, would you mind if Annie stayed here until tomorrow morning so that she could pack her bags without being in a hurry? Then you could come and pick both her and the check.
Whatever you prefer, sir.
Oh, Annie, baby.
It's okay. Well, we'll see you tomorrow, Annie, and then you'll be spending the rest of your life with us.
Bye, Annie, love.
Come on, we'll see her tomorrow.
Bye, Annie.
Yes.
Annie, why don't you go pack your bags, hmm?
Yeah, I'll go do that.
Well, what wonderful news. Are you sure that you've seen this man's wanted poster?
Absolutely. I remember how huge of a story it was. He got arrested and sent to prison. But I can't believe they let him out.
But suppose it's a simple misunderstanding. How will we have to pronounce us that these people really are her parents?
I don't know, Oliver. I've got the strangest feelings about this couple. And how did they know about the locket?
I don't know, but we must not risk Annie's well-being. I will not give up until we're certain.
But how?
I don't know. I'll find her. I'll go straight to the top. The President of the United States, even if he's a Democrat. Roosevelt is here.
Really?
Yes, you can meet him.
Yes. Do I need to take this?
No, you can leave it.
Okay.
Mr. President?
Good morning, Annie.
Hello, Mr. President.
Listen, Annie. Early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. He succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Nudge.
No, dear. David and Margaret Bennett.
What?
Yeah, Annie, you see,
Annie, you see, your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
Oh.
I'm so sorry, darling.
So I guess I'm an orphan after all.
Are you alright, Annie?
Yes, because I knew they loved me and they would have come for me if they weren't.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
I love you too, Daddy Warbucks. Now, who the hell are off for Shirley Much?
Well, the birth certificate could have easily been forged. But no one knew about the locket except for us.
And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Mrs. Hannigan, sir. And the children from the orphanage.
Come on, enter my little...
Hey, guys!
So shy.
Ah, Miss Hannigan, how delightful to see you.
Same here, sir.
Let me introduce you to everyone. You already know my secretary, Miss Sarah. And this is the President of the United States and the First Lady.
At your service.
My lord.
Mr.
Warburg,
this has just come
from
the
FBI. Now it makes sense.
Sir, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Good morning.
Good morning. We didn't realize this would be such a populated celebration.
Well, we don't want to bother or anything. We just have to pick up Annie.
And the check, of course.
And the check.
Yes,
of course. Here it is.
The president. Hello. Certified, paid to the order of... The jig is up.
Yes, the jig is up, Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dip.
Prof, I can't believe you!
Shut up, Lily, you're in this mess too!
You bitch!
Louis, stand over!
And I believe you'll find that woman is their accomplice.
I have never seen these people until yesterday!
Come on, Annie, you're coming down with us!
Annie! Tell them how good and nice I always was to you!
See, Miss Hannigan, I remember the one thing you always told me, and it was to never tell a lie!
You bitch!
Someday you'll land in a dark house with all the nuts and the spoon. Tucked away till the prohibition of
yeah.
And you won't have to work anymore.
Yeah.
And I'll make sure you all get adopted by good, lovely families.
Yeah.
And you'll be able to study! Come on, girls. Yes, girls, for you and perhaps for all of us, this very moment is the beginning of a wonderful new future. A new deal. That's a great name.
So do I, Frankson. I love it.
Now, come on, girls. Presents for all of you just right in the corner.
Great.
Yes?
When I talked about a new life for us, I meant all of us.
Wow.
And Annie, would you like to still be Annie Bennett Warbucks?
I would love that more than anything.
I love you very much, Annie.
I love you too.
Yes, I'm gonna tomorrow, so you have to. Tomorrow.
À tous ceux qui ont travaillé d'arrache-pied pendant plusieurs semaines, mois, surtout les 4 derniers jours. Un très très grand merci à toute notre équipe technique qui était vraiment merveilleuse. Merci au Centre culturel de Derghem qui doivent nous supporter pendant 2 jours folles. Voilà, vraiment tout le monde a été extrêmement professionnel. Je suis tellement contente que la vie recommence. Je suis extrêmement fière de notre petite Annie. Il y a encore 4 heures, c'était pas du tout ça. Je vous aime beaucoup, tous.